Woo, trying to get that paper, man. Yeah, what up, gang? What up, squad? It's your boy, you theorist, the realist, the coolest, the trillist, young king. Only two cover as we speak. Welcome back to another lit banger, gang. My dog, Fantastic Hip Hop, dropped. He's staying on top of this, bro. I like watching his stuff because he be really, you know, he be speaking some facts. He be spitting them facts. We got why Kanye dropped a Drake and J. Cole diss track. If y'all haven't seen my reaction to that, go check it out. I went bonkers, bro. Kanye was, he was spitting some, you know, it wasn't, you know, fire, but it was, you know, it was fake decent or whatever. Anyway, man, if you're new, subscribe, like the video, comment some more bangers you want me to check out. Let's go ahead and hear what my dog got to say.
As Kanye West just came back out of hiding to team up with Future and Metro Boomin on a remix of their chart-topping song Like That, it's clear that after Drake tried to shut down Future and Metro from being able to do just about anything on his diss track Push-Ups, this duo has pulled out arguably their craziest card yet as both behind the boards and in the booth. Kanye is right alongside them attacking Drake, and when it comes to his performance here, as Ye has taken a different approach than any other rapper against Drake has so far. It's clear that what Ye just did is going to change Drake's strategy in this feud going forward, as what he says here is pretty insane. And as he doesn't stop at just Drake and also disses J. Cole, Ye made more damage with this one verse than most rappers have in this entire feud. So with this new Kanye West version of Like That, while most remixes just ride out the success of the original song and just add another verse or two from some high-profile names, this remix completely revamps the record in a way where it doesn't just feel like a reinterpretation of the track, but it really feels like a sequel in its entirety as from start to finish. This cut builds on the original version, but feels more grandiose and intense than it did, which is really sad.
Yeah, it did, bro. It was hard. Like, he really changed the dynamic of the song, pretty much. Like, I want to hear us, like, the part, I want to hear, like, the his part and then Kendrick's part together. That'd be epic.
Saying a lot, considering how insane of a moment that it was. So with this remix, as Kanye West is the guy who takes the creative lead here, the track takes the DNA of what Future and Metro laid out and, in typical Ye fashion, ramps things up in the most unforeseen and unpredictable ways possible. Now with the production, Kanye takes the melody line that drove the original forward and replaces the loud chords with none other than vocal chants from the Hooligans, who were the group of people who did the background vocals on his chart-topping song Carnival, and with this group of fanatics adding a vocal presence to the song that feels so ominous and intense. The entire atmosphere from the original version of the song to the remix shifts as it goes from being an up-tempo banger to something that is genuinely sinister and evil. And with the-
Bro, he talking like he, like, I'm not gonna, like I said, I gave it like a 7.5, maybe an 8 out of 10. It was hard, but like, he was really, like, I don't know, it just wasn't hitting. Like, y'all can say what y'all wanted about Drake's last diss, but I like that one a little bit better. You know what I'm saying? It's just the fact that Kanye dropped against them. That's what is just mind-blowing, you know what I mean? Not the actual song.
This sonic atmosphere laying out everything to make the stakes even higher than ever. The stage is seamlessly set for Kanye to unleash sheer and utter chaos behind the mic, and despite how many people have been questioning Kanye's abilities as of recent, he finds a way to make the best run in this battle at Drake that we have really seen since Kendrick. Now with Ye's verse here, despite many people, including myself, questioning if he could even come at Drake lyrically anymore, is after hearing a lot of the verses on his last album, Vultures, it was clear that despite some high points like Burn, for the most part, Ye has never cared about lyricism less. But despite this, although Ye definitely spends a lot of this track just going off on a tangent that has nothing to do with the reason why he is doing all of this in the first place, he manages to make one of the more damaging lyrical barrages that he ever has, as in a rare moment for Ye, we see him directly address not one, but two rappers in both Drake and J. Cole, and after years of Drake continually coming at Kanye despite him waving the white flag. And with Ye finally publicly clapping back at Cole after years of sneak dissing. This is truly monumental, as in a time where many rappers have tried to kick around Kanye and his legacy, he shows that no matter how much people try to discredit him, he will fire back if you test him, and who to make a better example of than two of the members of the so-called Big Three. Kanye's more recent albums, especially with Vultures, have shown that as he has gotten older, his creative process has gotten way more unhinged and all over the place. What really was the best part about this track, and really served as the glue that tied it all together, was that for the first time in a while, what Ye did here was completely calculated, as from helping Future and Metro in a time where Drake made them look like the laughing stock with his diss track Push-Ups, to finally responding back to two of the rappers who have consistently been trying to diminish his legacy in the rap game for years. Ye's performance here had purpose like we haven't seen in a long time, and as soon as you hear this angry version of the hip-hop legend say that he has Kendrick's back and he wants to take Drake out once and for all.
I feel like he fought Kendrick battle, bro, and I even put that in the thumbnail. I said K out here fighting Kendrick battle, because he said, I got you, Kendrick, which I understand, you just saying you on his side, But I also feel like, nigga, you jumping in something that ain't got nothing to do with you. You know what I'm saying? But, I mean, it's cool, right? I'm just here for the beef. That's all. I say that shit every time. I'm here for the beef, nigga. Where my plate?
We see a demeanor lit inside of Kanye that has been rarely ever provoked, and on this actual verse. While Kanye talking about how he is still on top of the rap game despite all of the setbacks he faced definitely builds up his stature, and also having Ty Dolla $ign for a few quick lines come in and even tease that Vultures 2 and 3 are on the way definitely raised people's hopes from the ground about those records ever actually coming to fruition. What is defining this performance from Kanye are the shots he takes at Drake, most importantly, and while in the past, Drake has always been the one to get under Ye's skin. Here, Ye delivers some shots at Drake that are truly cold-blooded, as after Drake tried to make everybody he dissed on push-ups seem like they are his sons. Ye does the exact same thing to Drake here, but while Drake was pulling at strings to attack some of those rappers, Ye really hit Drake where it hurts with the lines, "Where's Lucian? Serve your master. You caught a little bag for your masters, didn't you? Lifetime deal, I feel bad." And with these parts, Ye schools Drake.
Damn, that shit went over my head, bro. I didn't understand that, and I heard it. I just didn't understand it, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes shit just go over your head, but he about to explain it right now.
He refers to Lucian Grange, the CEO of Universal Music Group, and talks about how the leader of the biggest record label on the planet pretty much owns Drake, and while Drake may have gotten paid pretty well in a deal with UMG that gave him his masters, he is still signed to them for a lifetime, according to Ye, so at the end of the day, he will never be able to have true freedom over his artistry and get away from the toxicity of the industry, and with Drake claiming that Kendrick was a pawn of the industry on his last diss track, Taylor Made Freestyle, which also came right after he clowned Kendrick's record deal on push-ups. This couldn't have came at a better moment, as Ye reminds all of us that at the end of the day, Drake is forever intertwined with the corporate machine that is the music industry in a way that only few artists are, and with this coming from Ye, who is independent now. Drake really has nothing to say against him.
Damn, what he said?
Corporate machine that is the music industry in a way that only few artists are, and with this coming from Ye, who is independent now.
Damn, Ye independent, bro? Oh man, that boy, bro, he really raking in bread. Now, he has that album come out, Vultures or whatever. Damn, pocket it.
Drake really has nothing to say against him, as all of Ye's projects are now reaping him 100% of the profits before they go to anybody else.
See?
Now, topping this off, Ye says that he can't think of a Drake line to close out his verse, which is just a way of really trolling him, but after Ye is done with Drake, he comes at J. Cole saying that if you play his music, you will get no girls in the funniest way he possibly could have said this, and with Cole dissing Ye on tracks like False Prophets and even Middle Child, it's only been a matter of time before he officially fired back at Cole, and with this one line. While this isn't mind-bending, Ye does a good job of humiliating Cole, very similar to the way Drake mocked Metro with just a single line on push-ups, and with this being another strain that J. Cole has taken ever since bowing out of this battle, all it does is continue to damage his reputation to the hip-hop world at large. So while Kanye only gives Drake and Cole a few bars on this track, they are delivered in a way where the impact is still much louder than most of everything else in this beef has been, as from Ye's stature in the rap game, to just the fact that he pretty much never calls out another rapper in a track by name that he's beefing with. This is truly an insane moment for this beef, as if everything that went on with Cole bowing...
Yeah, he name dropped Cole and Drake, so... Like I said, my nigga wants war.
Now, and Kendrick and Drake going head to head wasn't insane enough. Now Kanye West has fully stepped into this ring in a way that he never has before in his career, and with Drake seemingly being bored right now as he awaits Kendrick to respond. Who knows how he will react to not just having one, but his two biggest rivals ever dissing him at the same time, and if you didn't think this was enough, Metro Boomin may have one more chess move like this up his sleeve, as he liked a post hinting to the possible fact that maybe Pusha T will appear somewhere on one of his next songs.
Bro, so all in all, if he gets Pusha, cause you know they cool, if he gets Pusha on a song, Drake, you might be done, man. I ain't gonna lie, you've been hitting hard lately, but you might be done, though.
Kanye West definitely gets a point for this insane flip of like that, and for the powerful disses he threw at Drake that, although short in length, definitely say everything that they need to, regardless. I think the only problem with all of this is that it may not have been fully necessary on Kanye's end, but his teaming up with Ye seemed like Future and Metro's redemption in a way, after Metro especially got dissed pretty bad on push-ups.
He
this
did.
This could have been a move that was done more to help them than actually get Ye in the middle of things, but if Kanye actually wants to compete with Drake at the center of this feud at this point, I don't think he'll be able to fight him off with sheer lyricism alone, and if he wants to make a real statement, He should put the same type of calculation that we saw on this track, in Vultures 2, as if he can give us a body of work where we see Ye operating on a phenomenal level, not just in terms of the production, but also with his own bars and sequencing as well. In a feud where everybody's trading disses right now, Kanye can drop a storm of great tracks to make everybody remember that when he's locked in, no matter how old he gets and what he does, there are few musicians more talented than Ye. So let me know, how do you feel about Kanye West throwing himself into this all-out musical war, and how do you think he holds up to Drake at this point? I can't wait to hear what you have to say, and as this beef continues to get crazier and crazier, make sure you check out the suggested video explaining what started all these tensions between the entire rap game and Drake in the first place, because while it may seem like he's a victim right now, when you see the way he has treated so many people that are coming right at him, I bet you'd drop a diss track on him too.
Damn, bro, we might have to check that out. Comment right now if y'all want me to check that out. My thoughts on it, man, I really don't know what to think about it, man. I was just like, bro, if you ain't got nothing to do with it, why you? But it also could be a money move. You know what I'm saying? He's independent now. So anything he put out is going to bring more eyes to him, meaning more money. You know what I mean? So it could be a money move, or he could just be, you know, be like, hey, why you ain't come at me? Like, why you messing with my dog? Like, come fuck with me. Come holler at me. So, but y'all, what y'all think? Why y'all think you okay, Daddy? Why you think Kanye hopped in this? You know what I'm saying? Is he just being messy? Or, like, you know what I'm saying? Just say he need to mind his business type shit. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, man, like I said, go check out my Kanye reaction. My Drake reaction, both of them. My Kendrick reaction. I did all that, man. Go check them out. If you're new, subscribe, like the video. Comment some more bangers you want me to check out. Until next time, you boys out. Paul, what you got to say, man?
Bye-bye.
What?
Bye-bye.
Say bye.
Bye.
Good job, Paul. All right, man. My bad, y'all. Me and Paulito, gone. Hold on. All right.